In this segment, what we're going to do is we're going to take a higher order differential equation and we're going to solve it by using Heun's method, which is a Runge-Kutta second order method, one of the three popular Runge-Kutta second order methods. But we're going to take a second order differential equation and we're going to see that what do we get here. So we have 2 d2y by dx squared plus 3 dy by dx plus 5y is equal to 11 e to the power minus x. So that's the second order differential equation which is given to us, which somebody asked us to solve. And they've given us the initial condition that y sub 0 is equal to 7, and the first derivative of y respect to x at that value is 13. As we know that all the Runge-Kutta second order methods, fourth order methods, Euler's methods, the things which we have talked about of solving initial value, boundary value, ordinary differential equations, we find out that we are only able to solve first order differential equations by those methods. So we have to reduce the higher order differential equation or a couple order differential equation to a set of first order differential equations. And the way we're going to do this, this is second derivative here. The way we're going to do it is by assuming dy by dx equal to z. We're going to let dy by dx equal to z. What that will do is we'll reduce this to first order differential equation. So that'll be our first equation, dy by dx equal to z. And then when we substitute dy by dx equal to z in here, I get 2 dz by dx plus 3z plus 5y is equal to 11 e to the power minus x. And then I can rewrite this so that I can write it in the form which I need for my numerical methods, for Heun's method. 3z minus 5y divided by 2. That's what I will get there. And that becomes the second differential equation which I need to solve. So you have a coupled first-order differential equation now, which you can now solve by using any of the methods we have learned for solving initial value problems, initial value ordinary differential equation problems. So in this, I need an initial condition corresponding to that, and that will be y sub 0 is equal to 7. That's what I get from here. And then the initial condition here will be z sub 0 equal to 13, because I need the initial condition of z. Z is nothing but dy by dx. So dy by dx is 13, so I get z of 0 equal to 13 there. So that's my second differential equation. Now, this is my function f sub 1, which I will call, of x, y, and z. And this will be my function f sub 2 of x, y, and z, which I will need for setting up my Heun's method there. So you have this as your first differential equation, this as your second differential equation, where f sub 1 is nothing but z and f sub 2 is nothing but this function which you have there, which we have calculated. So now what I need to do is I'm going to use Heun's method. That's what I'm proclaiming, that I'm going to use Heun's method to be able to find out what the values of y are. So the problem statement, I didn't write down the complete problem statement here. And the problem statement is, hey, go ahead and find out what y at 0.5 is when h is equal to 0.25. So you're given that the step size is 0.25 and you want to find out what the value of y at 0.5 is. So that means that you have to take two steps, because you start from 0 to 0.25 will be one step, and 0.5 will be the next step. So what are the equations now for the Heun's method? Will be as follows, that you'll have y sub I plus 1 is equal to y sub I plus 1 half case of 1 y plus 1 half k2 y times h. Now keep in mind that unlike when we're solving just a single first order differential equation, we have to differentiate between the values of k1 and k2 between y and z. So that's why you have a superscript y here and a superscript y here, because that corresponds to the slopes which are calculated for y. And then you have z sub I plus 1 will have z sub I here. Z sub I plus 1 will be z sub I plus 1 half k sub 1 z plus 1 half k2 of z times h. So you do need to understand that here you have the slope on the z values, which you are supposed to substitute here. So these are different. These k1 and k2 are based on the value of f sub 1, and this k1 and k2 here, which are z here, are based on the value of f sub 2. Now, so what is k sub 1y? K sub 1y is nothing but the value of the function f sub 1 at x sub I, comma y sub I, comma z sub I. The independent variable and the two dependent variables, one which was introduced by us. And k sub 1 z will be equal to f sub 1, f sub 2. So k sub, let's write k sub 2y here first. K sub 2y will be equal to f sub 1 calculated x sub xi plus h y sub I plus 1 half k sub 1 y h. So you got to see that. Not one half, but k sub 1 y h. So you got to see that you need the value of k sub 1 y, the slope of y corresponding to k1, to calculate the next value of y here for this argument here. And to calculate the corresponding value of z, which you need k sub 1 z there. So it's very important to make the demarcation and the distinction between the two so that you do it right. So same thing here, which you have k sub 1 z will be corresponding to function f sub 2 being calculated at this argument, while k sub 2 z, which is the slope calculated at the point ahead, that's the point where we want to go, again the arguments will be the same as which you have here, which is x sub I plus h, y sub I plus k1 y sub I h, z sub I plus k1 z of h. Although I wrote them like this, you got to understand that you will have to calculate k sub 1 first. So this is what you have to calculate first. Then you have to calculate k sub 1 z. The reason why that is so is because you need k sub 1 y and k sub 1 z to calculate the arguments which are right here in the k sub 2 value. So then you calculate this c and this is d. So it's very important to understand what the sequence is. So many times when you do this problem, people do it, write a table out so that they know what the sequence is. I'm not going to use a table because it will be too lengthy to show on the screen. So I'm going to just do it step by step to show you how the value of y will be calculated.